I bow to the divinity in each one of you. My life can be divided into two. One is before mandalas and after mandalas. So, you can take a look at it. It is finding the flywheel using mandala. This is a washerman story. The washerman, once the washerman, the boy, and the donkey, they used to go every day to wash clothes. And the washerman used to keep the clothes on the donkey, and donkey used to carry the clothes. You can see the expression on the donkey's face. It's carrying the clothes, it's quite tired. So what happened was, when they turned around the corner, a few of the crowd which stayed there, they said, look at this guy, the washerman, can't he understand what animal rights are? What is he doing? He's giving too much load to the donkey. So the washerman said, yes, yes, it's correct. Let's do something about it. Then what happened was, the donkey started walking with them, the washerman started carrying the clothes. So they kept on going like this for a few days, and around the corner again a comment came. Look at what the washerman is doing. He is absolutely not doing it good. He is making the donkey also walk, and the child and the small boy also walk along with him. What is this craziness? So next day the washerman agreed to them, and next day what happened was this. The donkey was carrying the child, the washerman was carrying the clothes. So it went on like this for a few days, and after that again a comment came saying that, come on, what, you should really look at what animal rights are and look at what is happening. The washerman is carrying all the clothes, the animal is always tortured. And so later what happened was, the washerman was put on the donkey so that because of his tiredness, he can release of the tiredness. So every day this became the routine. The boy started carrying the clothes. And after some time, the people around the corner, they started talking, look at how things are. Again, another comment came up, and this is what happened. Later on, the washerman started carrying the donkey, and the child started carrying the clothes. My life was also something similar. I used to take whatever people used to tell me, I didn't have a clue of how to understand. I didn't have a clue of how to decide. So what happened was, over a period of time, I got into a very chaotic situation in my life where things were going here and there. I had no clue of what is happening. It was, my emotions were going overwhelming. My memory, I had a lot of forgetfulness. My body was in pain. I had arthritis by that time. I had, if I had diagnosed myself from this particular point, I would have said I had depression also. So I had no set goals. I was very tricky in talking to people. My relationships were very bad. I felt very insecure inside, and I wouldn't trust anyone. I was so adamant, and I was holding on to everything what I said. So that was very deep. And my body was in pain. Inside my mind, I didn't know how to contemplate, how to go about, what to do. I always wanted my parents, and I always used to blame my parents for whatever they have not done for me. So that was the situation. So at that time, I met, I would call her a sensei. Sensei is a person who has walked in front. She asked me to sit and meditate and do yoga. Yeah, I went and sat down. I had to sit still for meditating. So when I sat down still, my body wouldn't stay still. Like when I'm sitting down in meditation like this, my body would go forward like this, come back, and it will go left, right. Every second, every few seconds it used to do it, and I was not able to control it. The moment I start controlling it, it will start paining. So it was very severe, and one day I got a light bulb inside my head. And then I asked my body, what do you want to sit quietly? It said, I want to move. I said, okay, here you got it. After almost like 40 years of my lifetime, For the first time, I started dancing. I started moving. I got up from my meditation seat and I started moving whichever way way the body wanted me to move. And to my luck, actually, Tripura Kashyap actually conducted a workshop in Coimbatore. And I went and enrolled in the workshop, and it was a lot of movement. And the moment movement started coming in, my block started to get, it started disappearing. My adamancy started decreasing. And I started being a little open. So the mind started contemplating. The mind started thinking how to move about, what to do, when to do, where to do. How do we go about the whole thing? What is happening? So all these questions started coming. That was the first time I started contemplating. Then after that, I started running marathons. So body movement, marathons. I was an athlete from a childhood. So body was very good. I used to depend on my body. After some time, when I ran a marathon, my knee actually gave me a problem. I went to the doctors. Doctors told me you can't give much pressure to the knee because it can only be maintained. Otherwise, you will need a major operation. So that was the time which I really went down. The grief really struck me over there. And the things what I had was dance and movement, and that's what I was depending on, contemplation. And suddenly the whole world was upside down. The moment I start moving, something used to happen, and my memory used to fail me actually if I start jogging or if I start dancing. Then what happened was I stopped doing exercises, I stopped running, I stopped dancing, and I was still trying to meditate. So there was no movement. So one day, one fine morning, what happened was my sensei sent me a gift. She sent me a gift. When I opened the gift, it was a mandala. It was a picture. I didn't know it was a mandala. So I called her up immediately and I asked her, what is this? So she told me that it's a mandala. That's all she told me. But then she drew something which was very, 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 I was very curious about it. Then I started drawing. When I started drawing, this was how the chaos was. The chaos was like the middle one which I drew was for relationships of mine, which was actually going here and there. And on the left hand side, it was how my body was paining and how much anger I had. And on the right hand side down, it is like if I get somebody, I could literally kill, because I was sitting with so much of anger and so much of pain inside. So I started expressing using art. And luckily, the ones which are in the circles, they started calling it. I heard that they have a name for it, and they call it mandala because it is in circles. So then I started reflecting on the whole thing, saying that what is this happening to me? Why am I drawing these circles? Like I saw her and I started replicating it. Is that why it is happening? But it's happening in a tremendous pace, and mandala had become a practice for me, a practice 24/7. Any time when I'm free, I just go and sit and draw. So it was like 6-7 mandalas a day. I was mostly free because I was not doing anything, because so angry and so stubborn. Then over a period of time, my consciousness started getting clear. It started getting purified. Then I started learning how to look at each thought of mine. So it's like the mandala on the left-hand side. All those thoughts which are in the black and white are there, and I learned how to pick up that one single thought, one single movement inside me, and then I started plotting it, and like the tree, I started looking at the connections of that thought. Where is this coming from? What is happening? Where is it heading to? Why is that happening? And every time, it was one thought at a time. So the consciousness started clearing up, and this was what happened. The moment I found the path, the moment I understood the structure between what is happening in my mind and in my consciousness, this was the effect of it. I started drawing mandalas. So many mandalas came out of me. So many came out of so many different types of mandalas. The first one, which is on the left hand side top, it was the mandala which I drew when I heard a Rumi poem. The next one was when I started finding an energy, that go-getter energy inside me. That is what I found. So the bottom one was really this big actually. It was a big chart. I started finding that I could stick on to one job for a long period of time. It was patience developing inside me. So each mandala had a story. Each mandala had, it was creating an energy inside me, and that energy was creating an energy again inside me. So I started finding that flywheel inside me. Flywheel is something which is used in the sewing machines and in the trains, where the energy is stored in that wheel, and the energy which is stored in that wheel is actually double than that of its rotation speed. So it's a mechanical device which stores energy, and it stores double the energy. And what happened when I got this energy, and when I started identifying how to contemplate, where to contemplate, when to contemplate, which thought is going where, the first thing that happened was my adamancy changed into willpower. It started giving me a very, very good power from inside to go and get my goals happen, personal goals happen. The tricky person inside me who used to play tricks to get things done, it started changing into creativity. I no longer started playing tricks actually, not consciously. So the unconsciously, whatever that comes up, it starts coming out as creativity. It started drawing. I started finding different ways to draw, different ways to plot. I found that I had become very stable because I had understood my own fears. I know where to venture and where not to venture, and I know where I was frightened. I know that there is a sensation from inside the body. Still, I can go past it or stay within it. That's my choice. So I started understanding my choice. I started trusting people. I started accepting me as me. The entire chaos inside my mind, it changed into a structure. It changed into an understanding. From the pain, I started getting relief. I started getting relaxation. All my inaction, where before mandalas, I used to sleep for something like 16 hours a day. Now, actually, I work for almost like 18 to 19 hours a day, and rest of the time, that's all I need to sleep because I'm very peaceful inside. So, and my active imagination, that was the biggest part. When I start imagining, the imagination continues for a long time, like exactly the way I am dreaming. The dream doesn't stop till you wake up. It keeps continuing till the point it has to continue. So same way, my active imagination keeps continuing. If I want to sit and start imagination, it keeps continuing. One thought after another thought after another thought, naturally, innately, it starts coming up. So I started getting an awareness about relationship and how each element starts working inside and each element starts working outside. So that was a big revelation for me, because I saw a big connect between both. Orientation from negative, it moved on to positive. Then from anything what I do, any goal which I pick up, I started doing it with passion. So the achievement was like, it was very, I never thought about achievement. I just thought about the process and continued the process. So my emotions, I had become very vulnerable so that I can sit and relate with people. I started finding my own flywheel. Flywheel is this, and I am using the word flywheel in the term of using the emotional energy and the psychic energy. Yeah. Mandala actually means, it can be divided into two, manda and la. Manda means a container. La means aura. So mandala means a container that contains the aura. That's what it is. So that's what I started drawing. The mandalas are the ones which I started drawing on the paper. Just like we have a signature. A signature is not the person. A map is not the territory. Same way, the mandala which I have drawn on the paper is not the mandala. It's a signature of the aura. So the mandala is the person who draw. Mandala is the aura of the person of which it has been put forward. Just like what I danced earlier, I used to dance and identify. This time I was drawing and identify. So mandala on a paper is a gross form of your subtle energy. So these are the things which are, when I consolidate, these are the things which comes up for me. What we focus on expands and enhances. It is not just the experience, but it is the reflection also that you do upon it that actually helps you for a spiritual development within. Once we understand the reflective distance is the variance between whatever that has been drawn and whatever that is that you interpret. The difference between the reflection and actually what is there on the paper, once we understand it, we can add anything, delete anything, modify it, change it in our elemental memory. It can be done both in the subtle as well as in the gross. This complete thing brings in a conscious, in an order into the consciousness. Once the order has come into the consciousness, achieving any goal is very easy. It's a cakewalk. So I request all of you to actually draw the mandala. The best part of mandala, the best part of an art form of the mandala is you can either draw it or meditate upon it. You get the same result. If you are meditating upon it, you will have to meditate for a longer period of time. If you are drawing it, you are having the experience as well as the reflection, as well as the meditation to it. So I request all of you to actually draw or meditate and experience mandalas so that we can evolve collectively together.